रेडी। ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर कैलाश चंद्रा 235, टोटल वर्ड 800, एसएससी या एसएसबी के लिए है ये पैसेज। ऑडियो को थोड़ा लाइक कर दे, शेयर कर दे और सब्सक्राइब कर दे। वेन्यू विजुअल कंप्यूटर नियर किन इंस्टीट्यूट मुसलमपुर हाट पटना बाई एम एस सद्दाम। मोबाइल नंबर 9507142555। चलिए रेडी स्टार्ट। When the house rose last evening, I was in the midst of an argument concerning the propriety of exempting government companies from the provisions of company law. I wish to make it clear that where government owns 100% of the shares in a company, obviously many of the rules applicable to ordinary companies cannot be applied. Indeed, the well-known authority on modern company law summarized the position thus: it will be appreciated that the absence of shares and shareholders automatically renders large and important branches of company law totally inapplicable. Rules relating to the raising and maintenance of share capital, the control of directors by members, protection of minority shareholders, company meetings and the like can have no relevance. As we have said earlier, the knotty problem of the relationship between the management and the members is solved by the abolition of the latter. But the approach of our joint committee to this problem is difficult to appreciate. Government companies are put in a peculiarly privileged position. Last night I happened to pursue the minutes of the 14th meeting of the joint committee which considered this question. The recommendations submitted by the finance ministry miss the point. There have been exemptions suggested for certain types of companies, but I do not think that any purpose will be served by having any of the government companies other than those in which government has 100% shares brought within the purview of the exemption clause at all. We have to bear in mind that a government company in which 51% of the shares are held by the government is not a company which is the exclusive property of the government. It is one in which the government has a technical majority holding of the shares, and in theory, the government, according to the provisions of the bill, is given powers to revoke all the safeguards provided in the company's bill. Let me read out briefly the particular section which covers these exemptions. I want to ask only a few questions of those who have taken a prominent part in the deliberations of the joint committee. What is it that you seek to achieve by granting such an exemption. The government can, if it deems necessary, cheerfully decide one fine morning to exceed the overall limit of managerial remuneration laid down in clause 190. Of course, such a dispensation will be said to be in the national interest, and we would then have to reconcile ourselves to this change. Under clause 234, government has to entertain complaints from shareholders, but exemption from this provision can be made. Government companies, after all, are run by people of virtue. How can we ever entertain any complaint against government directors? Indeed, the blanket power that has been given confers on the executive full and complete authority to dispense with any or all the provisions of the Companies Act except two provisions to which specific reference is made. Of course, the argument would be put forward that government would not be unreasonable, that it will not exercise these powers. I fail to understand the validity of this argument. If you do not choose to exercise these powers, then why should Parliament give these powers to people who might not use them at some future date? After all, a statute is in existence until it is amended, and at any moment changes can occur. Someday a race finance minister might come to this house and dispense with all these elaborate safeguards which are meant to protect the interests of shareholders. I think it is morally unjust and constitutionally improper to confer these blanket powers on government. Have the legal consequences of such powers being given been examined? I have grave doubts whether this particular provision is in conformity with Article 14 of our Constitution. We have, after all, a written Constitution which assures equal protection under law. On what grounds of legality can we distinguish between shareholders in a government company and shareholders in a private company? I believe the courts would have something to say on this classification of categories which has been attempted by the Joint Committee. How can we strip them of their rights? The shareholders have already been stripped of their virtues by the government, which does not trust them, and now we are called upon to deprive them of their rights in government companies. Even in a corporation, a state corporation authority, it is true that shareholders have limited rights where an infringement of the statutory powers by the corporation occurs or where there is an infringement of their rights, the aggrieved individuals have a right to go to courts of law. Under this peculiar provision, if it is held.
चलिए हो गया ये, बंद कीजिए इसको।